Hidalgo.
Yes, my friend.
What brings you here? Is the village all right?
For now.
What do you mean? What has happened?
Men came, claiming we had to leave. They said that the land was being sold and that the Confederacy had consented. We sent an envoy, but they would not listen.
You must refuse!
We cannot oppose the Sachem, but you're right as well. We cannot give up our home.
Do you have a name? Do you know who is responsible?
He is called William Johnson.
Where is Johnson now?
In Boston, making preparations for the sale.
Sale? This is theft!
Connor, take care. These men are powerful.
What would you have me do? I made a promise to my people.
If you insist upon this course of action, seek out Sam Adams in Boston. You'll be able to help. What have you done?
When my people go to war, a hatchet is buried into a post to signify its start. When the threat is ended, the hatchet is removed.
You could have used a tree.
Can you help me? Bloody hell! Can you help me?
Are you all right?
What do you think?
How did this happen?
Poachers in the woods. I asked them to leave. This was their answer.
Come on. We need to get that arm looked at.
What if the men who did this?
They can wait. Your wound cannot. You be able to make it to the house?
Yes. I think the ball took only flesh.
And what is your name?
Miriam.
Do you live nearby?
I don't have a home per se. I took to the frontier when I was a young girl. I've made my life out here ever since. Living where the land makes it easiest.
Not a common choice for a woman of the colonies.
No, it's not. But truth be told, it was this, the convent or the brothels. I prefer the open air.
Kana, what are you doing?
Those poachers need to be stopped.
I saw the scabs from my hunting blind. Get to that, and you shouldn't have any trouble finding them.
Use the rope dart if you can. Get familiar with it.
Thank you. William Johnson's opening up some of that Mohawk land he purchased for free hunting soon. Might be we make a good haul up there.
I hear tell lumbering will be allowed to boot.
What's going on with the territory if not...
Hey! Where are you, fellas?
Shooting strangers in the forest, is that common hunting practice where you come from?
No! Spare me! Go!
Tell the friends you have left what happened here.
Thank you, Achilles.
You are most welcome.
Why did those men attack you?
It's no secret this land is full with game. I spotted the trespassers en route to request permission to hunt here myself, and suggested they do the same.
The bounty of the forest is not mine to give. It is your right to hunt on this land, but I would appreciate you trading your surplus with the others.
Very well. I accept.
Read all about it.
Intentions and demonstrations won't suffice, Sam. We need to act, and I'm talking about more than a sternly worded letter.
I sympathize with your frustrations, gentlemen. But surely you can understand my reluctance to kick the hornet's nest. Ah, Connor. Hello again. What brings you to Boston?
You.
Would you excuse us, fellows? Thank you. That conversation was about to turn unpleasant. Now, what can I do for you?
I was hoping you could help me locate William Johnson.
Of course. I'm headed to a meeting with some men who should be able to help. Why don't you come along? Well, it's good to see the people finally taking a stand against injustice.
Says the man who owns a slave.
Ooh, sorry? I practice what I preach, my friend. She's not a slave, but a freed woman. At least on paper. Men's minds are not so easily turned. It's a tragedy that for all our progress, still we cling to such barbarism.
Then speak out against it.
We must focus first on defending our rights. When this is done, we'll have the luxury of addressing these other matters.
You speak as though your condition is equal to that of the slaves. It is not.
Tell that to my neighbor who was compelled to quarter British troops, or to my friend whose store was closed because he displeased the crown. The people here are no freer than Surrey.
You offer excuses instead of solutions. All people should be equal, and not in turns.
It's in turns, or not.
It's my home, no matter what you thieves called taxmen say. If the gumps in Parliament who want to take my property, you tell them to sail across the pond and take it themselves!
It's not open for discussion now. Open this door or these men will break it down!
Ah! Ah, bollocks! We're coming in!
Ah! I trust the mounting evidence is proof enough, Connor.
Continue on. I shall meet you at our destination.
Could use some support. Could use some support. Is that all you have? Could use some support.
Justice for once. I dare the governor to send more.
You all right?
I'm fine. It's not my first dance. For all their teeth and claws, these little foxes, they fight like puppies. Thank you, my friend. I'd buy you an ale, but I'm expected somewhere else.
Connor, I'd like you to meet some like-minded friends. The owner of this fine establishment, William Molyneux, and the manager and chef of his newest venture, Stéphane Chaffaut.
Ah, Connor and I just had a ball with some red coats enforcing some taxmen outside my home.
The collectors grow bolder and more forceful. Something we must address, Samuel.
Then let us raise a banner. Something to let the people know that they are not alone. The docks are an angry place of late. Protesters picketing the latest shipments of British tea. The eyes of the city are upon that stage.
A Bostonian without his tea is a dangerous beast.
William Johnson is smuggling the tea off the ships. One of his men tried to sell me this. A sample of what I refused. But it's from those ships. No mistaking the stamp. He's charging a king's ransom. Must be he's making a mint off those who buy it.
Where is he now?
I've never met the man.
May I ask why you seek him, Connor?
He intends to purchase the land upon which my village stands, without the consent of my people.
No doubt the revenue from his little smuggling endeavor is financing the acquisition. A tax enforced on tea grants a boon to smugglers. I'll wager the same men who levy the taxes are selling the tea. A stage requires a spectacle, and I may know the play. Connor, head back to the docks and see to the destruction of the tea.
Pardon me.
Oh, come on, mate.